Hi, parents and families. My name is Amber Garvey, and I'm a member of the Instructional Technology staff in Henderson County Public Schools. I want to take a few moments to walk you through how your child will use Google Classroom, the ways you can get started, get logged in, access assignments, and turn things in. We want this to be an easy process for you. So let's take a look at what you need to do to get your child logged into Google Classroom. If your child is using a Chromebook and has already turned it on and used either his or her badge to log in or their email and password, you can skip this step. But for those of you using personal devices, you'll want to open up Google Chrome, go to a new tab in the Google window, and when you see Sign in the top right-hand corner, you're going to click that button. Then enter the child's email address. Click Next. Then enter the child's password. And click Next. Once you've logged into Google, you'll notice in the top right-hand corner that you now see an icon. This could be a picture that your child has used to indicate their Google account, or this might just be an empty person shadow. So what you're going to do is click on the little 9-box icon next to that called the waffle menu. So click on the waffle menu and go to Google Classroom. Once you're here, you will see any classes that your child is already a part of. However, this may be the first time your child is going to their teacher's Google Classroom. Your teacher would have provided a code that looks similar to this. It may have been emailed to the child, or it may be something that the teacher called and told the student the code for. But what you're going to do is enter this code into Google Classroom so that you can join the class. So to make it easier for me on this computer now, I'm going to select this and copy it. You could select it and copy it from the email, or you can simply type it in. Either way is fine. But I'm going to copy this one. And I'm going to go back to my Google Classroom window that we logged into, and you'll notice in the top right-hand corner, there's a plus sign. So if you click on that plus sign, you're going to join class. After you have the class code, you can paste it in or type it in, either way, and you're going to click join. Now, Google is joining you to your teacher's Google Classroom. So once you're in the Google Classroom, you'll be able to see the title of your teacher's class and some information. I want to just walk you through this just quickly so you'll know where to find information in Google Classroom. You'll notice there are three tabs across the top: the Stream tab, the Classwork tab, and the People tab. The Stream tab is where you'll find announcements for your class. So any announcements your teachers share, you'll see here. The Classwork tab is where you're going to see all your classwork. The People tab is where you're going to see your teachers and other students in the class. This is a test class that I'm using, so there's not a lot of people in here to interact with, but you'll still get the idea. So when the teacher assigns something, this is how it will look. If you're logged into Google Classroom when your teacher assigns you something, you will see Stream was updated. So I'm going to click Show, and you'll see that I have a new assignment. So I'm going to click the Classwork tab to see my assignments. I see a category here. My category or topic is Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and I have one assignment under it. What I want to do is click on View Assignment so I can see everything in one place. Here are the directions that my teachers provided to me. So it tells me to read chapter 1, so I can go do that. It says there's a read aloud here if I'd like to access the read aloud. And then it says complete the attached document. Well, I don't see any attachments here, and that's because it's over here. It's already attached for me. The teacher has provided a Google Doc that I need to finish. So I'm going to click on that Google Doc, and I'll notice it put my name at the very front. And then it's given me some questions. So what I'm going to do is fill out the answers to these questions. And when I'm finished, in the top right-hand corner, there's a turn in button. So I'm going to turn it in when I'm finished. Now, we understand that lots of times families get busy and maybe you can't finish assignment all in one sitting. So even if I start this, and I don't get finished, I can close that tab, log out of classroom, come back later, come back to this assignment, click on that document again, and it's still going to have what I just wrote. But when I'm finished, I'm going to click turn in. When you click turn in, it'll say, are you sure you want to turn that in? And then I say, yes, turn in. And then my teacher now sees that I've turned in my work. Once something is turned in, when you're inside Google Classroom, it shows me that it's grayed out now because I've completed it. But if I wanted to open it, it also shows here I've already turned that in. I do want to show you a quick little thing that you can do at the top. Now, this is only one assignment in this classroom, so there's not a lot in here yet. But you know what? Notice at the top it says view your work. At any time, you can click on view your work and it will show you a list of all your assignments, when they were due, and if you turned them in or not. So anything that was missing would show up here. Or I could use the missing tab and I see, oh, there are no things that are missing. And there's nothing that's assigned that I haven't finished. So that's a really quick way to get to how you're doing in classroom. Now, I do also want to show you another type of assignment where you might have to submit something to the teacher that they've not already provided. Now my teacher has assigned me a paper that I need to turn in. So I'm going to, and I notice this button is a bright color, so I know I haven't done that yet. Like this one that I've already turned in, that's gray. But I'm gonna click on that and go to view assignment. You'll notice there are no attachments to this assignment. So here I can add something that I already have, like a Google Drive file, a link to a website, or an attached file, but I can use this to create my new file and it will be linked to this assignment. So I'm gonna click Docs and it will attach a Google Doc directly to my assignment. Notice it even puts my name and the title of the assignment, and this is where I can start typing my paper. Again, when I'm finished, I can click turn in. Now, I'm going to close this and show you that it stays attached to this assignment. So that's a super easy way to make sure you don't have to keep looking for your files when you need to turn them in to the teacher. Also, if I had a link that I wanted to share with my teacher, I could add a link and it just asked me to paste in the link. So if they had asked me to find my favorite website or something that I want to share, I can post that there. When you're finished with everything and you're ready to turn it in, there is a turn in button on the assignment. If there are more than one thing attached, that's okay. You can turn in. And then your teacher gets notified that you have completed your work. So that's how to access Classwork tab. Now there also may be times when your teacher asks you a question in classroom. So here I see I have a question, and I know it's a question because it has this little question icon. So if your child gets asked a question that's multiple choice, they can simply choose their answer and turn in. So these are quick ways that the teacher may ask some questions to either see how they're doing or assess their learning in a quick way, but there may be a question that's asked. So I'm going to go ahead and put a sample answer in and click turn in. And now I know this is finished because again, it's grayed out, and if you open it up, it says turned in. If at any time your child needs to email their teacher, they simply go to the People tab and click on the little mail icon next to the teacher's name. They don't have to go to Gmail. It will automatically open up for them. It also puts in the teacher's email address, and that they can type in their subject, whatever they want to say to the teacher, and click send. So that's a super easy way to stay in touch with the teacher. Now, there may be times, especially during this remote learning, where your child needs to be online in a Google Meet. So let's talk about how that works. So my teacher has posted something and it says, "Good morning, hope you're having a great day. I'll see you every morning at 8 for our class instruction on Meet. Use the link at the top of the classroom to join." So at the top of the classroom, you may see a Meet link. This is a link that your students use to join their class. So this is for live instruction. And when you're ready and it's at that time that you're supposed to link, you'll click the link. You'll have to make sure that your camera and microphone have access, so you'll click allow. You can turn off your camera here. You can turn off your video here. And when you're ready, click join now. You'll want to make sure the teacher is already in the room before you click join now. Another quick tip about Google Classroom is in the upcoming box, if your teacher has due dates on any assignments, you'll see that list of assignments that are coming due. That's just a great little reminder to help you, but that's only if they put due dates on it. So again, the Stream tab is where you go for announcements and also for your Google Meet link. Your Classwork tab is where your teacher is going to put your assignments and you'll be able to see what you've done and what you haven't done. Remembering there's that little View Your Work tool if you want to see your work. And there's also a Google Meet link here too as well. Then on the People tab, you'll be able to email your teacher if you need help. So this is just a little overview for you as a parent to see how your child will be able to move through Google Classroom. Remember, at any time that you need help, you can also use the People tab and email the teacher to ask for help as well. We hope that you found this super helpful. Thanks for all you do to support your children, and we hope that they enjoy using Google Classroom with their teachers.